Oh no.
You got a point there.
Point there. Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield, and we're going to another district, but something here. Oh, yeah, Saburo. Oh, optional. Tell him about her feelings. That's from one of the offices back in there, I believe. Yeah, Celt Corps. Up on one of the other floors.
Out of my face.
Out of your face. I'm just running past you. It kind of happens. Sometimes people will pass you. This is normal.
I wonder how many poor souls who couldn't make it in New Atlantis ended up working at the fisheries in Neon.
Well, you go look into that. Find a number for me. I wonder what this is for. Anyway, hi.
I'm confident my fellow business people will see the benefits of the cross-promotion.
Yeah, I hope it works out.
Thank you for handing out those flyers.
No problem. Clover McKenna offered to pay off your debt to Celt Corps.
Oh, she did. Miss McKenna is very kind, but I cannot accept.
But you must.
It is my responsibility to pay the loan. If I cannot, then what happens, happens.
Really? Show him the diary? That's kind of a violation of privacy, but I don't know Clover from a hole in the wall. Just talk to her for like a minute. Okay, so here, read this. It might change your mind.
Really? Let me take a look.
Take a look?
Oh. I did not know she felt this way. She is always so professional. I thought she did not like me. That is why I have sent proxies to negotiate my debt.
Proxies? It's okay. Some people are just oblivious to that sort of thing.
I've been told the only thing thicker than the rock on Volai is my skull. But lucky for me, Miss McKenna was able to look beneath the surface. Regardless, you have done me a service, and for that, I thank you. You can tell Miss McKenna, I mean Chloe, that I accept her offer.
Accept the offer. For the money or the nookie? Okay. Are the feelings between you and Clover mutual?
I do have feelings for her, and maybe now I will have the courage to tell her. I know they say never to mix business with pleasure. But there are always exceptions.
Okay. Yeah, it's all kind of strange. I mean, who knows how long they've been talking back and forth about this loan, so yeah.
Thank you again for helping me out with the flyers.
No problem. I guess we'll run back to her before we go to the other district, or one of the other districts. The underbelly and the... I forget the other one. Yes, be quiet, Windows. She is willing to pay off his remaining balance. No new text. We will return. Shut up. You see someone sprinting and tells them to move along, right? Yeah, this is the one we want.
While we're here, you better stay off the Aurora. You don't want that drug scrambling your brains.
Put an arrow in the knee.
Clover McKenna, at your service.
Hi.
If you're here to buy, I'm afraid we only sell direct to retailers.
Oh, you want to look up and see who you're talking to. Saburo agreed to let you pay his debts.
That's fantastic.
I was worried he'd take it the wrong way, so I'm glad you were able to convince him.
Yeah, you stop cleaning now.
I'll arrange for the funds to be transferred immediately. Hopefully Father will forgive the late fees. And if he doesn't, I can always reimburse them when he retires. In any case, thank you. And here, for your efforts.
Where did that come from? You have not stopped cleaning since I walked in here.
Thank you again for your help with Saburo.
No problem.
Have a fine day.
And to give me that activity to do, I've already visited my apartment. And the activity thing did not go away.
Get lost. I have a job to do.
I'll shoot you. I'll do it.
What are you looking for?
A butt that looks like a face. Or a face that looks like a butt. I can't even figure out. Oh, Hotel Volai? Yeah, let's...
You didn't hear this from me, but those ecliptic mercenaries, the factions
a wide berth, yes. Okay. I've already visited it. We will visit it again. Here. Visiting.
Wow. You are the soundest sleeper I've ever seen.
You mean heard. Fastest. So it doesn't go away. I have to rest like a whole 8 hours or something? Check out our apartment over and over. I mean, that's what it's indicating, the bed. I've slept on the bed, I'm jumping on the bed, I've skip jumping with my pack on the bed. There's nothing else to do. Guess that activity will just stay there forever. Pick something else.
Welcome, off-worlder, to the Hotel Volai, your home away from home here on Neon.
Ebbside, okay, we're going to Ebbside. What we've heard is true. This is the most dangerous district on Neon. Hi.
Hopefully Neon treats you well.
Thanks.
Sleepcrates for rent. It's tight, but it's home.
Sleepcrates, huh? Inza?
Be careful around here. Not everyone that stays in our sleep crates are reputable.
People actually live in these things?
That they do. It's the families that really get me. And when those families can no longer even afford a sleep crate, well, that's just my favorite part of the job.
Your favorite? What? When they can't afford one? Wait. What'd she say?
That they do. And when those families can no longer even afford a sleep crate.
That's your favorite part of the job, when they can't even afford the sleep crate? Can you tell me about sleep crates? I mean, I really want to ask her about why she enjoys people not being able to afford to live in a box. Can you tell me about sleep crates, then?
If you're struggling, sleep crates are the budget accommodation choice of Neon. It's tight, It's got a smell that's an acquired taste. If you're in the market for a sleep crate, they sadly sell themselves because they're very, very cheap.
Okay. Like some details on purchasing a sleep crate.
Good for you. You can at least get some privacy that way. No weird stains, save the ones you spill.
Oh, yeah?
And it just so happens we have a deluxe shipping crate that recently came on the market. Built for cargo, redesigned for people. Just the thing for a minimalist like yourself.
What makes you think I'm a minimalist? What do you mean by minimalist, yeah?
It's an artist's way of saying less is more. Minimalism is about shedding life's excesses. One night in a sleep crate and your desires, comfort, and hygiene will molt away.
Your hygiene molt away? Your comfort? Yeah, I'm not interested.
Smart choice. I'd say you dodged a bullet, but you're the one holding the gun.
Okay. Who's that? I need access to Nesher Osmani's sleep crate.
You have the proper authorization code, and I'll let you into any place you like. I might even throw in a thank you. You look like the type that might appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, right. Is that meant to be a compliment?
More of an observation. Not much to do around here, except clean up after people that have partied too hard and drink. Hmm? Don't get much of a chance to talk to the respectable type.
Hmm. Yeah, I was glad. I was wondering if I had to... If this was an old school game, I'd have to write this down, but... Oh, she looks creepy when she smiles like that. The code is Alpha 3 Kilo 4... I don't know what quest it is. It's... Oh, is this the guy? No. This is the guy in the... He's in the city lockup. He's in the jail. They needed help with something for us to get something for him. The code is Alpha 3 Kilo 4.
I got it. And authentication is all green. Look for C153. Before you go, I'm going out on a limb here and assuming your account's more flush than my usual clientele. I've got some evicted crates set up to go to the dump. Might be full of weak old Kazembas, or it could have the original Miguel Rafael Bailamos.
The what?
Only one way to find out.
What's a Bailamos? Loose ends? What's this about Bailamos?
A brilliant piece of art. It celebrates when the colonists first broke ground on Polvo. The vids make it look stunning. All done in charcoal from the embers of their first fire. Well, so the story goes. Nice to be able to use my art history degree for once. Pro tip, when your parents say there ain't no use for a degree, they aren't lying.
I'll take a chance on the crate. Okay. There might be goodies inside. Okay, this is only 1,000. Yeah, I'll take a chance on the crate.
Great. Unit C203 is now keyed to you. Best of luck.
Thanks. Go to the evicted sleep crate. Oh, I just remind myself. Loose ends, right. I've spoken to the sleep crate manager and they've given me access to Nesha's sleep crate. I should now search the tiny rental space for Yannick's package. Right, Neshar. I forget exactly what. It proves his innocence or something, I don't know.
I have some sleep crate units available for rent, but... Someone like you. I got loads of crates for rent. For next time.
We can get another crate? There's Frankie's over there.
Pardon me.
Pardonne-moi. Oh, A107 key.
Be careful around here. Not everyone that stays in our sleep crates are reputable.
Not reputable.
got no idea.
I just came to eavesdrop on your conversation. Over here. What do you want to call it? Frankie's grab and grow. Open all time.
Today, open all time. Sucked.
Food, drinks, at open. Okay. So this is not a sleep crate. It's not even as good as a sleep crate. You have some stutters here. I'm just gonna restart real quick.
The colors. Colors.
Yeah. The colors.
Already.
That's credits.
Yeah, I saw the trailer for some of
them. If you think credits are rubbish, give me all yours.
I am hyped.
Neshar's this is it. Neshar's package.
Is picking back up.
Good for him. Saburo's a nice guy.
Saburo, I'm talking about Saburo. What's in the box? What's in the box? Tell me what's in the box. It's Gwyneth Paltrow's head. Yep, right in there.
You just haven't had a run-in with those Baroon crazies.
Hello.
Hello. Alright, let's go to Frankie's grab and go and talk to this guy. That guy. Moonshine pot? Oh, I saw you outside too. Opened container. Unfolded. There's a computer terminal around here, and I'm gonna find it. Is it this one?
Need something?
You are a female, Frankie. What opened? I guess there was something on this side. Yeah, you hear that? Well, hi. Oh,
what'll it be?
Sure for Francesca?
You lost, kiddo.
That's not supposed to be an H in Francesca. Am I lost? This is a store, isn't it?
Sure. I just don't get too many quality customers here.
Quality?
Most folks head over to Newell's or the Emporium if they've got the creds. I'd say less than half my customers are legit. The others are just kids up to no good.
No, I'm just looking around.
Yeah, well, make it quick. I ain't a fan of loitering.
Huh.
I had some high hopes for this shop back when my husband and I opened it a while back.
Browsing.
These days, if you ain't a regular, you're usually trouble.
Not loitering. What do you sell here?
Snacks, drinks, odds and ends, typical convenience store fare. Thought we'd snag a few of the Astro Lounge clubgoers who might want something to go on their way home. Turns out we were more appealing to the local gangs.
Well, that's true. You're not really. You are in a different district, but technically not that far away from the Astral Lounge and the Trade Tower. Did something happen?
Of course something happened. Ain't that always the case? Let's just say those hopes died a long time ago, and there ain't no reviving them.
Well, you won't get any trouble from me.
We'll see about that.
Are you going to apply for the job?
Someone's looking for a job here. How much business do you get back here?
I may not be on the main strip, but I make enough to keep me afloat. Lucky for me, my regulars are a devoted crew.
What type of people are your non-regular customers?
Mostly tied up in those good-for-nothing gangs. Those disciples and strikers always fighting over who gets to run the place, and not giving a damn over whose lives they ruin.
Disciples and strikers, huh? You said you started this business with your husband?
Solomon thought a small convenience store with cheaper prices would make a killing. Of course, the only killing made was when he got himself shot in a robbery.
Oh, damn.
Now it's just me running this place, so you can see why I'm not a huge fan of strangers in my shop.
Well, I'm a stranger with money. Tevin Anastas told me a thug named Headlock hangs around here.
Never heard of him. Now, are you gonna buy something or just annoy me all day?
The latter. I really need to know where he is. Yeah. I mean, I could think of quitting out and taking a Hippolyta and going back to this, but yeah, I need to know where he, really need to know where he is.
How am I supposed to know where he is?
Well, I know you'd like to help me if you could.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Tough customer. Okay, I understand. I'm not trying to make anything difficult.
Look, I'd like to help, but...
Sure, we can work something out.
Yeah, I hope so.
You're saying no now, but if I annoy you enough, you'll say yes eventually, right?
Okay. That's pretty good.
Huh?
You just won't give up, will you?
Moody.
Yeah, I know Headlock can't stand him. And I heard some of the other Seokguh can't either. That boy doesn't know how to keep himself out of trouble. What'd he do this time?
How do you know Headlock?
He's a customer. You're not here to interrogate me, so let's get back on track.
He's been terrorizing the Emporium.
Well, if any place should be terrorized, it may as well be the Emporium.
It's kind of your competition.
In any case, if you're so desperate to find him, he and his friends are probably hanging out in Warehouse 4 somewhere near there. I gotta ask, what are you gonna do with him?
It's called, forensic... organ restructuring. No, if you can't stand Headlock, why do you care what I do with him?
I have no affection for him whatsoever. He's a good-for-nothing thug, and a boastful one at that. I wouldn't mind seeing him get smacked around and put in his place. But that doesn't mean I think he should be killed.
Alright. I just want to talk to him.
That's one way to punish him. You'll just bore him to death. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a business to get back to. If you aren't gonna buy anything, you better run along.
You're insulting me? So I'm gonna bore him? Deal with Headlock? What do you have for sale, then?
Hopefully it's something you need.
Maybe. Yeah, I did your picks. Oh, chasm bass oil for crafting. Okay, you don't have Med packs. That's pretty nice. A chem designed to improve pain tolerance. Battle stim. Plus 250 damage resistance for 5 minutes. I got it. Some tough battle come up. It keeps killing me. Maybe that'll help me out.
See you around.
See ya. I want to get back here and use the computer. Bayou Plaza that way. Okay, so I came in here. Obviously we're doing the quest, but I'm going to explore the whole place like I do. Did you pick?
Is it really necessary for you to drag around all that gear?
Shut up. Did you pick? 297 creds. 288. 322. 300. Oh, there's one more. $267. All right, so what's up here then? Yeah, interesting. So there's this whole other level. Oh, we got stairs going even higher than that. Pressurized. Oh! Seokguh Syndicate hideout. Pick my way into a gang hideout. Oh, crap. Don't do that. Scare the hell out of me. Oh, we can hear them. I'm just gonna go kill these guys now? Subterfuge? I like subterfuge. Is leading me in here. Mag pressure tank. Product verified. What's behind the ladder? Paramagnon conductor. What are you doing? Why are you going all the way up there? Just go say hi.
I'm watching. No funny business.
What is this? What you got here? Sand sculpture. So he doesn't seem to care that we're here.
Sure, shaking down shop owners is all good. But I'm just waiting for him to try and resist.
Maybe they think I'm one of them. I'm not sure if I should like that or not. Oh. Grunt issue 2. I'm missing that one. Gotta complete my grunt set. Ballistic weapons permanently do an additional 5% more critical damage.
Why are you bothering to carry all that junk?
You're being extra annoying right now, just have you know. I just improved my ballistic critical damage. Are you daft? Oh, cool. Yeah, I wonder what this thing is. This thing is powering? There's some kind of power source. Again, computers. I hear them and I can't get to them. I mean, I can't even open that. We could jump up there, but we've got stairs, so I guess we'll use them.
Sorry. I'll remember for next time.
You remember for next time.
Back off. You try anything, you're dead.
What if I try to walk this way? Does that make me dead?
No funny business. I'm watching you.
Always seems to know when they're watching. Well, so we got a lot of half-eaten food. Packaged food. Cooking station. Choose your chunks now with sauce. Oh my god. The horror. Oh, that squall thing. Oh, I can take this? Credit stick? 238. Oh, the others were stealing. That one's free.
I wonder where this leads.
Yeah, same. That's a master lock, so I'm not gonna find out where that leads right now. Stand by, guys. Ooh, I'm like in a plant. I'll be right back.
A joke, huh? You want me to tell one of the lieutenants you think the boss is a joke?
Whoa, whoa, daughter. Funny thing is, that's not what I thought. That's what I thought. They keep the boss's identity secret. So it is like
back around. Hi.
You try anything, you're dead.
Yeah, I've been hearing that lately. You guys don't like me to try things. Greetings.
Back off.
You guys are almost as friendly as the guards in the other sections.
Back off. I'm watching you.
No, you're not. Your back is to me.